Finance Unit Section 1, Compute Markup, Retail Price, and Markup Rate. We want to establish a retail price of an item. To do that, we'll use the following formula. We're going to take the cost plus the markup, which has been found based on a percentage of the cost to equal our retail price. In this example, we have a level with a cost listed here of $39.19. And this business is charging a 25% markup on this item. We need to do a percentage problem to calculate that amount. We'll take the cost, which is acting like the base, timesing it by the markup rate. Markup rate has to be expressed as a decimal, so moving that decimal place to the left, we have a 0.25, resulting in a value of $9.80. Adding that to our cost will give us the retail price, or the selling price. If we went into this business, we would pay $48.99. Here's another example asking us to determine the retail price. We have a portable welder with a price cost of $373.03. The markup rate that this business is using is 15% of the cost, so our calculation will entail taking the cost times the markup rate, 373.03 times the 15% as a decimal, giving us a markup amount of $55.95. Adding those two together will give us the retail price or selling price of $428.98. To compute a rate, we can take part divided by base in a percentage problem. In this example, it states that on a 32 question driver's license exam, a test taker got 29 correct. What is their score as a percent? The base is always the total quantity. This will be the 32 questions, and the part is a portion of the base, and in this case it's the number of questions that this test taker got correct. So putting 29 in place of part, 32 in place of base, and then doing the calculation, which involves taking the numerator 29 divided by the denominator, we end up with a decimal. Rate is always expressed as a percent, so we're going to move our decimal place two places to the right, which would give us a 90.6. And if we express that as a whole number percent, it would be enough to call that 91%. Using that shortcut, we can calculate this markup rate problem, or one similar to it. You have a trade-in of your car for $5,600. That would be the cost to the car dealership. They put a selling price of $7,400 on the car, and this problem is asking us to compute the markup rate applied to the car. So using the relationship part over base, our base is going to be the cost of this item. The part will be the markup amount. Well, the trade-in amount that the dealer paid for this vehicle was $5,600. To determine the markup amount, we need to take the selling price minus the cost. The difference between those two values will give us the markup amount. Subtracting, we end up with $1,800, and now we're ready to finish the calculation by taking the numerator divided by the denominator. This will give us a decimal, but our markup rate needs to be expressed as a percent. Moving the decimal two to the right gives us a 32.1% markup rate. In this example, we have a circular saw with a dealer cost of $168 and selling for $224.97. The problem is asking us to compute the markup rate. We'll use that relationship of markup amount divided by the cost of the item. Well, we have in the problem what the cost is, $168, and a small calculation is involved for us to calculate the markup amount or to determine the markup amount. And that will be found by taking the selling or retail price minus the cost of the item. When we do that subtraction, we find a markup amount, the difference between the cost and the selling price of $56.97. And then to finish up this calculation, we'll take the numerator divided by the denominator to give us a decimal. And to convert it and express it as a markup rate, we'll move the decimal 2 to the right and say a markup rate of 33.9% was used to determine this retail price. You should now be ready to do some practice found on page 12 in the textbook.